There are new questions this evening about racially charged threats sent to the president of the Spokane NAACP. Rachel Dolezal received a mail last February that contained pictures of African Americans getting hanged. And now, as you first saw on KXY 4 News, major crimes detectives have concluded the envelope was never processed by the U.S. Postal Service, despite the fact they were found in the organization's post office box. KXY 4's Jeff Humphrey brings us up to date now and up to speed on the investigation. Jeff?
The envelope was addressed to NAACP President Rachel Dolezal. The 20 pages inside included pictures of lynchings and of Dolezal making speeches like this one. Dolezal told us back in February that she felt threatened.
I immediately was struck by pictures of guns pointed towards me, you know, the viewer, and no more hesitation in writing, and also pictures of lynchings, pictures of me speaking at the Martin Luther King rally.
Investigators then went back to the Rosewood branch where the NAACP gets its mail in this locked post office box. Detectives were told the envelope Dolezal had received had not been canceled, time-stamped, or imprinted with the barcode that directs mail to the right destination. According to the police report, the postal inspector told detectives the only way this letter could have ended up in this P.O. box would be if it was placed there by someone with a key to that box or if a USPS employee was involved. So then police then interviewed the three postal employees who put mail in post office boxes, and none of them remember seeing the envelope. In fact, all three said if they had, they would have at the very least canceled the stamps. The detective wrote, "I have no reason to believe any of these employees were involved in putting the letter in this post office box." Customers who rent post office boxes are given a pair of keys. The locks are changed every time the box changes hands.